signs of a struggle. For all the good it did.
Greetings. Will you break?
Where do I go from here? Have to keep going.
quickly.
I don't fancy their chances. Get too close.
This is your end.
Wish my luck again.
I'm so tired. How do people do this all day?
Assume nothing. Worth examining.
Someone there.
Should be easy. wanted the easy path.
Sword alike were used to ravage this battlefield.
Imagine the glorious din of it all. The streaming banners, the charging knights, the piles of severed limbs and heads.
I'd rather not. It's all the same to you.
Crooked touch. Step lightly. Mind if I do? This this battlefield must have ran slick with blood. I can taste it in the air, even after so long.
Dead of the Emerald Enclave. They lay here ever since their war against Ketherick Thorn.
Time's over, pet.
Ah, I love this time of year. The dickheads start popping up wherever you look.
What do you want, Mizora?
Drop the attitude and perk up your ears. You've got a new mission. Absolute's cult has gone and grabbed one of Zariel's assets. A devil. And a powerful one at that. They're locked up in the cult's fortress, Moonrise Towers, and you're getting them out. Will, your playmate's wasting precious time. Let's see about getting his priorities fixed. Clause Z, Section 13. Should promised soul refuse obeyance or neglect duty, the pact holder shall cast the promised into Avernus as a lemur. I'll make it simple. Will fails or refuses, and he turns to a thick blob of stink flesh and sinks to Avernus. Now, be a good boy and play fetch, pup, or you'll spend an eternity sizzling in the hells.
Mizora's words may be flippant, but they are tinged with desperation. She cannot afford for Will to fail this mission. This may be your best chance to negotiate Will out of his pact.
Oh, and what condition is that?
Your mind links with Will's, drawn in by his increasing panic.
What are you doing?
Will relaxes, and your connection fades.
Interesting. Now, why should I go letting my favorite pet off his leash?
From a children's story, said to void a devil's contract. Abi diabole et nunquam ready.
I've never seen such a fearless display of sheer idiocy. Bravo! Fine. I'll play your game. But I amend the pact once the mission's done, not before. Clause F, Section 9. Soulbinder shall bestow reward or favor only upon Soulbearer's fulfillment of related obligation. Now, to Moonrise, pet. And do mind the shadows. They've been especially hungry.
Need to find a way forward.
You know, I feel a connection between us. Like we're two souls walking the same path. You might be a little naive in the ways of the world, but I see promise in you. Ambition. I just worry that we're not considering all our options when it comes to our uninvited guests. How many people are infected with them, do you think? Hundreds? Thousands? And they're not just goblin trash. There are powerful people in the Worm's Thrall. Whoever's waiting for us at Moonrise Towers controls it all. But if we can take that control from them, imagine the power we'd wield. I mean, I assume there's some device controlling these things, so we find that. Murder some people and, look, I'm not a details person, all right? But turning up and causing chaos has worked for us so far. I'm just saying, there's an opportunity here. If we can control the tadpoles, we can keep ourselves safe and liberate the world from this evil. It's not often the universe hands you something like this. We'd be fools to squander it. Of course, this all assumes we live long enough to find this, moonrise. But I'm feeling optimistic.
God damn it! Why did it have to be Mizora? Why did it have to be Zariel? We're supposed to risk our necks to get one of her assets. What if it's a runaway like me? Or something far worse? I want to believe that as much as you do. Almost as much as Will does. But I just know there will be more to the story. There always is.
It's a bad idea to play games with the devil. You'd never win. Not ever.
The more bullshit she pours, the more of it I'm forced to swallow.
Mizora set me on fiends inside and outside the Hells. She's never ordered a rescue.
Gods. She makes a mockery of everything the Blade stands for. Such an asshole.
The same thought crossed my mind. I am only to hunt the infernal, the demonic, and the heartless. But nowhere was it stated that I can't help one. Either we find it, or I'm made a mindless blob clawing at demons on the front line of the Blood War. And it means everything to me. I always knew what my future held, and I know I chose right. Thank you. For sticking your neck out for me. I mean it. But I'm not going to celebrate till I'm actually free. I can feel Mizora scheming, plotting. She won't let me go without making a fuss. Trust me on that. Then we know our mission. All roads converge at moonrise. I was 11 when the Counselor spotted and slayed an assassin who stalked Father from the shadows. I was 13 when she brought word of a goblin warband advancing on Rivington. Her keen scouting saved 100 lives that day. The Counselor's loyalty to my father is beyond question. She's as steady as Tyr's heartbeat, as upstanding as the Sword Mountains.
Father's at Moonrise Towers, and we need to save him. They want violence, they want control, they want Baldur's Gate. Who better than Grand Duke Ravengard to surrender it? Who better than the commander of the Flaming Fist to dismantle its defenses? They will infect him, and the city's guardian will become its ruin, unless we put a stop to it. We can't and we won't. The shadows be damned.
I wasn't expecting it, but I'm glad to have some company on this journey.
Difficult to say. A fellow servant of the Nightsinger would surely be an ally to me under most circumstances. But something doesn't add up. I'll need to see where his allegiances truly lie.
Fine. What's on your mind?
I don't think I've ever had a confidant quite like you. And if I have, I can't remember them.
Greetings. Mark my words, this power would be no blessing, but a curse. You might as well ask me to gouge out my eyes for the promise of sight, or slice off my tongue for the promise of taste. Consume all the gate tadpoles you wish. I'm not so craven. Gladly. It is over where I am concerned. It is through conflict that we strengthen our bonds. Yet I do not recommend Shadowheart seek it again. The next resolution may not end in her favor. I understand much beyond your comprehension. More to the point, I know the cure for our condition. It is imperative we locate a creche. You do well to observe more and question less.
How can I help?
Oh, you know me, ever the optimist. I'm trying to focus on the positives. Truth is, I was living on borrowed time already. Consuming those items would only have kept the orb sated for so long. If anything, I feel more at peace than I have in months. At least now I know my death will have purpose. It won't be a distant bang in the footnotes of history.
Ah, yes. Karsus. Karsus was perhaps the most powerful wizard that ever lived. The child who would be a god, the elves called him. And he tried. With a spell of his own devising, he endeavored to usurp in one fell swoop the power of the goddess of magic. Mistril, she was called then. Imagine what it must have felt like to be a god. To know yourself, to be untouchable, to be mistaken. As Karsus aimed his spell at her, she began to unravel, and with her, the entire weave. Too late did he realize what he had unleashed. It would have been the end of everything had not Mistral sacrificed herself. The goddess of magic is all magic. By dying, the entire weave was lost, and the spell that challenged a god failed. It was the end of Mistral. The end of Karsus and the end of an entire civilization. As the child who would be a god was turned to stone, his empire came crashing down around him. The floating cities of Netheril were no more. An event that came to be known as Karsus's folly.
For a spell. Mistral was reborn as Mistra. Upon her return, the Weave returned with her. Now, so many centuries later, I try to follow in the footsteps of Karsus. Not to destroy Mistra, but to prove my love for her. I tried to control only a fraction of the magic that was unleashed that fateful day. I merely sought to return one tiny diamond to an imperfect crown. Gale's folly, one might call it. History. Repetition. It's the way things go. She expects those who seek to use the Weave to do so honestly, and with respect for its potential to destroy, as well as its potential to save. I doubt she's asked many of her followers to blow themselves up. That's a fate she's bequeathed exclusively to me. She wouldn't ask such a thing if it weren't our only means of survival. However much she's annoyed at me.
You recognize the feathered creature. It's the owlbear cub you rescued. The cub tilts his head. He does not trust you. Yet. He steps closer, hesitantly.
What a delectable little pet.
Alarmed by your companion's approach, the cub turns heel and runs.
Oh, now look. You've scared off the little snack.
With a grinning face, this cold iron flask is sealed with a...
Long road ahead.
wags his tail, a small bag clenched between his teeth. He gives in and surrenders his find to you. Scratch's tongue lolls out happily, his tail wagging even faster.
Indolence breeds madness.
Salutations.
All's well that ends. Not as bad as it could have. How much farther can I go?
Every day, my queen, your followers are legion. Your faithful stand ready, Majesty. Soon we march. Soon the world will bow to you.
Yeah, we're boss. Something moved up there. Want me to drag it out?
Stay in the light! They do not go into the dark!
Didn't figure something as big and ugly as you for a coward!
No! They will not go into the dark!
Enough! Stop!
They will not become shadows! They will not feed the curse! Forgive me, my queen, but I had to. Before the dark got any stronger. Close, little ones. Do not leave the light. Shadows and heretics, Majesty. But they won't stop us. They can't stop us!
Wonder if the gods are watching me. Inside.
Easy these days.
sounds macabre. Ah! Swift as my feet can carry me.
Lantern gives off a chilly glow, protecting all in its vicinity from the surrounding shadows. You notice a tiny pixie trapped within.
Oh, please! Oh, golly, me, oh, my! You must release me or I'll die. This lantern only lights the way when I am hurting night and day. My pixie dust is bright as day. My injuries can light the way.
Bah! She cannot be more pained than my own ears from that insufferable rhyming.
I dare not name it, newfound friend. The faintest touch could spell my end.
Finally! Been trapped in that coffin with no one but a mad rider and my own farts for company.
Did me a good turn there, didn't you? What do I owe you?
Sure I can, but will I? Yeah, sure, why not? Here, give this bell a shake. Speak the magic words and you'll get what you've earned. Protection from the shadow curse. What more could a dingus want? You're welcome.
Curious little thing.
Maggots will be done. To a Githyanki crash. Our cure is nestled in the mountains. The further we sink into shadow, the further the crash. We must take to my people. They are our only means of cleansing. Pursue this path further, and I will go alone if I have to.
An efficient path.
Centuries old, from the looks of it.
I've got a long road ahead.
Well, hello.
Eager for battle, without delay.
Fallen members of the Emerald Enclave. Casualties in the war against Kethric Thorn years past.
Some rests better than none.
Curious.
What now? A crooked touch. One step at a time.
Magnificent.
That's curious. Curse that desecrates the ground itself. Almost impressive.
Quite ready for you.
Wait.
Action, not reaction. Proceeding.
to do.
Indolence breeds madness.
Let me work my magic.
Still breathing, despite everything.
Burn.
Victory awaits.
forget my name.
Mistake.
Ah, excellent choice.
Enough waiting. I crave blood.
On my feet.
Looking ahead.